took 2 steps forward and you took 5 steps back, and you're saying, God, what in the world is going on? And I was sitting in my kitchen and I didn't understand it. And then these words came. I said, Lord, you are good. You've been so good. Lord, you are good. You've been better than good. I can't praise you enough. I owe you my life. Can't praise you enough. Even if I try, 'cause you've been so good. Lift your voice. Come on, tell them today. You've been so good to me. Let's go right here. Everybody lift up your voice.
So Lord, you are good. You've been so good.
Come on, say, Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good. You've been better than good. I can't praise you enough.
It's because I owe you, Jesus.
I owe you.
Somebody say, even if I tried it, it wouldn't work. 'Cause
you've been
so good
to me.
Hallelujah to your name, God. Come on, lift up those voices and declare today, Lord,
you've been so good.
Lord, you are good. Even if I tried, it wouldn't work because. Come on and lift up your voices.
So good
to me. Come on, say,
Lord,
you've been so good.
You've been so good.
I don't know why you do it, God, but God knows we're grateful. Of our Savior. So many doors.
So many ways you've made.
So many times. Has He been better than good to anybody? So many
doors.
So many ways. So many times. Tell somebody, you've been better than good to me. Declare out of a hard place. that you've still been better. I can never repay you, Lord. I can never repay you, Lord.
God, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. And I am glad about it. Thank God for this new day, this new time, this new opportunity, this Thursday, the 22nd of July. We praise God for it. Praise God for every one of you. Thank you for tuning in to this time of prayer. Listen, if you are out there, like what we're doing, share what we're doing on your page, invite someone else, tag them to be a part of our prayer time together. Comment, respond to the comment. Christ is risen, and you know the response to that. He is risen indeed. Amen. Hey, also give us your I am statement. We'd like to know how you're feeling. Sometimes it's just good for you to express it, good or bad. Listen, give it on up, but give it to God. That's the key. Give it to God. That's the key. Also, name at least one thing the Lord has done for you. I know you have a plethora of things that you can say as it relates to what God has done for you today. But just give us one thing. It's good to keep that before us as well. Keep our focus on how good God really is. Amen. Listen, we are here for our time of prayer. I'm not going to waste yours by doing anything else but getting us into it. James chapter 4, verse 14 is our scripture reading for today, connected to our daily devotional reading, God's purpose for your life. I do want to encourage you to continue to stay up, stay current with your daily devotional reading. James chapter 4, we'll read that, verse 14. We'll do our model prayer. We'll do the prayer takeoff from the book. And today we'll be praying for racial reconciliation. Racial reconciliation, healing even. Amen and amen. James chapter 4, verse 14 reads like this. Whereas you do not know what will happen on tomorrow, for what is your life? It is even a vapor that appears for a little time, a little while, and then vanishes away. Then vanishes away. Let's pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us, O God, this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who have trespassed and sinned against us. Lead us not, O God, into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And Lord, we know you can do it, for thine is the kingdom, the power is yours, the glory is yours forever and ever. Hallelujah and amen. Lord, we're so grateful you will guide us and guide our future, because we know, Lord, you have never let us down. We know then that you never will. Hallelujah. Lord, as we pray today on this touchy subject, on this subject, Lord, that has gained momentum, the ugliness of racial indifference and separation by race, by culture, by ethnicity. Many have been hurt by this financially, hurt by this physically, even have been killed because of this. There's so much going on. We're divided as a people. We're divided as a human race. We're divided ethnically. We're divided culturally. We're divided racially. We are divided in our communities. We are divided, Lord, even in the local church. We are divided in government. Lord, it is sad. It is sickening. Yet, if we would just hear you say, love your neighbor as you love yourself. If we would just hear you say, help one another, love one another, pray for one another, lift one another. If we could just hear your words and heed your words, all of this would be different. All of this would go away. We know Satan is continuously sowing seeds of discourse, continually stealing and killing and destroying and dividing. But Lord, he has no victory here. You said, I come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. And I know, God, we know that a part of that abundant life is our unity. here on earth. A part of that abundant life is that we would love one another and care for one another. Lord, I know this sin is going to last throughout time, but yet it doesn't have to be rampant, yet it doesn't have to be as big as it is, yet we can make a difference where we are. And Lord, let it begin with us. Let it begin with True Vision Church. Let it begin with this community. Let it begin here, Father, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, let every community, I pray, Lord, for Joshua and every community, and Moses and every community, Paul and every community, Lord, and Mary and every community, and Elizabeth and every community, Lord, those who will stand up in your name and fight for what is right, and Esther in every community in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray for those who think they are superior to other people, who think that they are better than other people, who treat other people not as people, but as less than. I pray, Lord, and lift them to you, that their hearts will be pricked, convicted, and changed in the name of Jesus. Lord, let it start in our pulpits as we preach the gospel and preach the truth and stand on it and show everyone what is true from your word in the name of Jesus. We count it as done. We believe it. In Jesus' name we pray. For those who are on the line with me now, I lift them to you, cover them and keep them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you, saints. Thank you so much for tuning in and being a part of our time of prayer. It means so much to me. I pray that this time is sacred and means much to you as well. Thank you again for tuning in. Praise God for the technology he's given us to be with one another today. Love you with the love of the Lord. Hey, hugs and kisses to you all. Bye-bye.
His name. Is there anybody in this place that is here to bless him? Let me hear you make some noise. Come on, here we go. Say it. Magnify.
Magnify the Lord with me.
Come on, sing it to him. Sing it.
Whom the Son he hath redeemed.
Come on, set. Clap your hands. Like this. Shoot again.